I'm expecting fun, creative roots. These guys have been setting for a long time. They really know what they're doing, and they put a lot of time and effort into the roots, so they should be amazing. I hope there's some burly, powerful stuff and some funky, techie stuff too.
My name is Alex Queering, and I'm 24 years old. And over the past couple days, we've been setting up for this comp, putting problems together, making sure everything's going to run smoothly throughout the competition, and just making sure people are going to have fun.
What do I like about root setting? I just like the fact that you can create. You can pretty much put your ideas up on the wall and have other people enjoy what you've created, giving them the ability to kind of see and understand what you had in your vision and get them to do what you want them to do is pretty cool.
As a root setter, qualifiers was very entertaining. We kind of had specific grounds as to where we were setting and what we were setting, so having those guidelines made it pretty easy to set what I needed to. Forerunning also, it was really, I've never actually numbered problems before, I've only contributed to setting before. So the forerunning and kind of deciding what was easier and what was harder, it was cool because it was a collective discussion and everyone got to share their opinion.
My mama told me when I was young, we're all on superstars. She rolled my hair and put my lipstick on in the glass of her boudoir. There's nothing wrong with loving who you are, she said, 'cause he made you perfect, babe. So hold your head up, girl, and you'll go far. Listen to me when I say, I was born this way.
Problems that we've put together. We got some big volumes, we're gonna change some of the angles so competitors aren't gonna really know what to expect, because if they climb on the wall before, the angles are gonna change and they're gonna have to think up new strategies getting up the wall. Hopefully we get some people slipping up because they are having to think about sequences and not so much just not being able to burl through the problems. The women's problems are set sort of a mix of styles. We've got some burly problems to make them thug their way through these problems, and we've also got some problems where they're going to have to think, or if they'll be rewarded by thinking.
We have a great team this year, and just really shows how hard we're working when everybody is psyched and everybody makes it into finals from the girls' side.
Obviously, too, from the adult team, she is one of the strongest climbers I've ever seen. And I've only actually gotten to know her climbing this year, but hands down, she'll take the cake and win.
is a little powerhouse. And there's some European chick, maybe, I heard, that's climbing super strong, so it'd be cool to watch her too. Predictions for girls. I think Elise Stefna is climbing really strong.
She's definitely a force to be reckoned with. I, you know, almost wouldn't hesitate to say that she's going to be the one to watch.
We're going to be Elise again, but we'll see what happens, I guess.
We have a couple dark horses in the mix. We have a German girl, I believe, who we've never seen compete before. But we've also got Elise Stefna, who is always a crusher. But I think that we could see a couple of the girls move up a lot in the ranks. So it's going to be an interesting final for women as well. I'm really excited to see how they're doing as well.
Finals were great. I came out expecting that they would be, you know, kind of World Cup style problems, and they were. And really focused on technique and balance and power.
Problem number four was my favorite problem. Probably just because it was really flowy, it was my style. I like the two end holds, those blue circular ones. Fun to hold on to, and yeah, it was just a lot of fun. The second route still, I actually like those kind of routes. Those are actually some of my favorite kind of routes when I guess them, but they're ones I always need to work on, because just that balancey stuff, really techie, is just not my style. I train in a bouldering gym that I train power a lot. So to get on those kind of routes, it's definitely a wake-up call. Gotta work on it, and gotta work on your weaknesses and come back stronger.
Yeah, I thought the girls did really well. The underdog came up on top, which is good. Marta from Norway surprised everyone. She did all the problems, which was awesome, and she did a lot, two of them in the last minute, so we did a lot of climbing today. Very impressive.